Hi friends, I am Vinod Shankaran. In this video, we are going to discuss about chi-square test and its applications. Chi-square test is frequently used to test hypotheses concerning the difference between a set of observed frequencies of a sample and its corresponding expected theoretical frequencies. Though it is a continuous distribution, its main application is on discrete variables whose frequency can be counted with or without tabulations. In this video, we are going to discuss about chi-square tests and its applications for various testings by using Minitab software and suitable examples. Now we will see the application of chi-square tests. It can be used to test population variance through confidence intervals, test if more than two populations proportions are equal. Now, if there are only two population proportions, then we can go for a two proportion test for the comparison. But if it is more than two population proportions, then we have to use chi-square test. Next, test for independence. So here we are going to test the subject under study whether it is depending on any particular factor or not. So the factor can be man, machine, material, method, measurement, anything of that sort. Next, test for goodness for fit. Now we will go one by one. The first one, the test for population variance through confidence intervals. Now we will see one example. One supervisor of a screw manufacturing company claims that he has done some improvement in his process on his machine and he has reduced the variability in the diameter of screws. The original variance was 0.01 inches. Now 20 samples were taken after doing the said adjustment or the improvement and the variance measured in those 20 samples and the results was 0.009 inch. Now we want to see that whether is it sufficient to prove the supervisor's claim. So our null hypothesis is that variance before improvement is equal to variance after improvement. This is a statement of equality. The null hypothesis is that the said improvement has really not done any change in the original variance or the population variance. Now the alternate hypothesis is saying that yes, the variance before improvement was more than variance after improvement. That means after improvement, the variance has been reduced. So this is the alternate hypothesis. So we want to test whether the supervisor's claim is correct or not. Now we will see that how we can do a test for population variance by using Minitab software. So here we have to go to state, then basic statistics, then we have to go to one variance, then we have to put all the values here. Our sample size is 20, then sample variance is, we have seen it is 0.009 inches. Then here we have to do perform hypothesis test. Then we have to put the population variance, that is 0.01 inches, or the original variance was 0.01 inches. Then we have to go to options. Here we have to say that the variance is, we have got three options. Variance is less than hypothesis variance and not equal to and greater than. So in our case, hypothesis variance is less than the original variance. So you have to press there. Then you have to say okay, then you have to say okay. So you will get the answer over here. We got the session window from Minitab. Here mainly we have to look into the confidence interval at 95%, which is coming here, and the p-value. Now if you look into p-value, you are seeing that it is 0.583, and the rule says that if the p-value is above 0.05, means we are failing to reject the null hypothesis. In other words, the supervisor's claim that he has improved the process is not correct. Actually, no significant improvement happened in the process. Next, we'll see the second application, which is test if more than two population proportions are equal. So as I said earlier, if there are only two population proportions, we can go for two proportion tests or two p-tests. But here it is more than two population proportions, then we have to essentially go for chi-square test. Now we will see it with an example. One HR department plans to introduce a policy change regarding compensation structure. He wants to see the opinion of different level of people in the hierarchy. So he has taken the opinion who prefers it and who opposite to the policy change. So he has taken samples from entry level, middle level and senior level. So here are the result. Now here the null hypothesis is saying that proportion of each levels are equal, and the alternate hypothesis saying that not all proportions are equal, at least one of them are different from each other. We will see how we can do it in Minitab. So we have entered all the data, opinion which is prefer and oppose, and for the entry level, middle level and senior level. Here we have to go to state, tables, cost tabulation and chi-square. Here we have to select summarize data in two-way table, and we have to enter entry level, middle level and senior level. In the row we have to put opinion, and we have to do counts. Here we have to do chi-square test and expected cell counts. In fact, we can do other tests also here, but mainly we have to look into these two. That's why I am just putting these two only. You have to say okay and okay. So here we got the result. So these are all the observed count and this is the expected count. And secondly, we have to look into the p-value. So the p-value we are getting 0.325. So the rule says that if the p-value is above 0.05, means we fail to reject the null hypothesis. In other words, there are no significant difference in opinions between different levels of executives. Now we will go for the third test, that is test for independence or interaction. There are four machines A, B, C, D, which produce three kind of outputs, first grade, second grade and third grade. One quality engineer wants to test whether quality of the product from four machines are the same. So first, machine A produce first grade 620, second grade 130, third grade 50. Likewise, each machine has its own outcome. So quality engineer wants to know that whether it is depending on any particular machine's behavior or is independent. Or in other words, all the four machines give the same output, or any particular machine or any one or two machines give different outputs. So the null hypothesis in this case is that output outcomes are independent of machines, and the alternate hypothesis is that outcomes are dependent on machines. Now we will see that how we will be doing it in Minitab. So we have got the machine A, B, C, D and its first grade, second grade, third grade, that is put over here. And now we have to go to state, tables, chi-square test for association. Here we have to go for summarized data. Then we have to enter machine A, B, C and D. Then we have to put here machine, and here we have to put this chi-square test, and display counts in each cell, display marginal counts and expected counts. So you can do further also the test, but we are mainly focusing on expected outcomes and the observation, observed counts and the expected counts. Say okay. Okay. Now let us look into the session window. Here we can see that these are all our observed counts for each machines, for each grade, and its corresponding expected counts are calculated here. And secondly, or mainly, we have to look into the p value. The p value, if you see here, it is 0, 0, 0. And the rule says that if the p value is below 0.5, means we have to reject the null hypothesis. In other words, our outcomes are dependent on machine. And if you really see here, the machine C, even though the output is less, the second grade and third grades are actually more than the other machines. Now we will see the fourth test, that is the test for goodness for fit. Under this, actually we try to find out how far the observed value of a given phenomenon are significantly different from the expected values. So one example, a die, we all know that it has got 6 faces. A die is thrown 132 times and the following are the results. So number of turn up, it is given here, and the frequency 1, that is this one, 16 times it has happened, 2, 20 times it has happened, like that 3, 4, 5, 6, against that its frequency, it is tabulated over here. Now, our null hypothesis is that the die is unbiased. If the die is unbiased, the reading will be more or less same only. Alternate hypothesis is that die is biased. So this is what we wanted to test, whether die is biased or not biased. We will see how it is done in Minitab. So we have given the same data here, the number of turn up and the frequency. Now we have to go to state, tables, chi-square, goodness of fit test. Here we have to put the frequency and number of turn up, and we have to say there is a graph given here. I am just not putting graph here, just saying okay. Then okay, so here we got the result. Now we will see the Minitab session window. These are all our observed counts for each phase, and these are all the expected counts. And it is expected that each phase should have equal number of counts, that is 22. And here the most important thing is that the p value. The p value, it is given, it is 0.109. And the rule says that if the p value is above 0.05, means we fail to reject the null hypothesis. In other words, the die is considered as unbiased. So friends, thank you very much for watching this video. I would like to get your sincere feedback. Also request you to subscribe my channel and share this video to useful people. My email ID is, you know this, 2014050504@gmail.com, and mobile number 9190430414139. Thank you once again.